Hey everybody, it's your AP Biology teacher, Mr. Poser. Today we are getting into topic 7.3 in our unit on evolution and natural selection by discussing artificial selection, which is a really interesting topic, I think. I think it's all interesting, but this is particularly interesting for me. So we beat the concept of natural selection to death in the last couple of videos. Okay, but I'm gonna say it one more time, just for good measure. Hey, if you don't remember, here it is again. Natural selection is the process by which individuals with certain inherited traits that allow them to better survive and reproduce in their environment are going to pass down those favorable traits, and they're going to better survive and reproduce, and they're going to pass down those favorable traits to their offspring, thus pushing change in a population over generations. That's what natural selection is about. Okay, and natural selection, who does the selecting when it comes to, natural selection? The environment, okay? Whichever organisms are best fit for their environment are going to be the ones that are going to pass down those traits, okay? The environment selects which traits are going to be best, okay? But what if they don't? What if the environment doesn't select the traits? What if we select the traits? We as in human beings. Well, that can cause evolution too. And there's some very extreme examples of how evolution can take place in all of our domesticated plants and animals. Okay, particularly dogs. We're gonna talk about that here in just a second. But human selection of traits can affect variation in other species just as much as natural selection. Okay, so if we decide which traits that we want from organisms in the next generation, and we can pick the organisms that breed and pass down those traits so that we get more individuals with that trait, that's artificial selection, also known as selective breeding. Take a look at this. Hey, this animal right here, this is the ancestor of all modern dogs. It is Canis lupus, the gray wolf. Okay, all modern dogs are evolutionary descendants of the gray wolf. There we go. Okay, now, how did we get to all of our different types of dogs? We have French bulldogs, chihuahuas, poodles, greyhounds, salukis, golden retrievers, black labs, you name it, bull mastiffs. Okay, how do we get that crazy variety of dogs, especially this guy over here, I'm a big fan of him. How did they all descend from this wild animal? Well, very early on in human history, right, when people were mostly hunters and gatherers and society hadn't, as we know it, had not been established, people that didn't settle down and stay in the same place and grow crops, okay, people were hunter-gatherers, meaning they went from place to place to place to place to place in order to find food. And they were nomadic, right? And as a result, humans had to compete for resources, for food, with other predators in the area, particularly the gray wolf. Okay? So some wolves were perhaps born with a trait that made them more docile or made them more friendly to humans, okay? So that when these gray wolves and these humans met each other, you know, the gray wolves weren't like, hey, I'm gonna eat you. It was more like, hey, can you share some of that food with me? That's how it was, okay? So what happened was, over time, you know, how did they become man's best friend? Well, people bred these wolves. They bred them in order for them to pick the traits that they want out of their wolves, okay? We want the more friendly wolves, okay, that aren't gonna try and eat us. And then that became, oh, we want the wolves that will stick around and will, you know, not be part of their pack. Now we want the traits that, you know, the wolves are, I don't know, they're more loyal or something like that, okay? And it kind of happened. Well, I don't want to say naturally because this is artificial selection, hey, but it happened over many, 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 many generations of these wolves that eventually became dogs, okay? We as in humans picked traits that we wanted to see in the next generation. Hey, if I want a pug or something like that, Okay, it was like once upon a time. Oh, wow, look at how flat this dog's face is. It's so cute. What if I breed this flat-faced dog with another flat-faced dog? And then I'm going to breed those dogs, and their faces are just going to become flatter and flatter and flatter and flatter. And that's how you end up with a pug. Okay, and here's its descendant right there. Here's its wild ancestor. Okay, so humans bred dogs for desirable traits, i.e. cuteness, docile nature, friendliness. Okay, maybe they're really good at, you know, there's shepherding dogs, there's boxers, right? There's there's farm dogs, there's hunting dogs. Okay, all those dogs have different traits that we wanted out of them. So we picked the ones that got to breed. Same thing that we did with plants, with all of our different crops that we have. Wheat used to be just like a grass, okay? Just a normal grass. All these fruits that we have, they're not nearly as big and juicy and edible as they were today until we picked traits. We picked the ones that were the best for us, okay, that advantage us the most, and we bred them. And thus their traits changed over time to become more desirable for us. Take a look at this. This is wild mustard plant. You might actually even see this around. Hey, this is the ancestor of all four of these different types of vegetables that we grow as crops now. Okay, so individuals long time ago, you know, like they found these mustard plants that were like, oh, these have bigger flower buds and stems. Let's breed the ones with the bigger flower buds and stems, and they'll become bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. Okay, and eventually we got broccoli. Same thing with cauliflower. These plants have larger terminal leaf buds. And then we bred them and bred them and bred them and bred them and bred them to get bigger and bigger and bigger in terminal leaf buds, thus cabbage. Okay, same thing with kale and their leaves. So all four of these vegetables, okay, that seem very different, all have the same common ancestor, which is a wild mustard plant, okay, that we just picked the traits that we wanted and allowed them to breed, okay? It's pretty incredible what we can do with artificial selection. Hey, and something that we'll talk about in class a little bit more is that, you know, a dark side of science here is that many scientists believed that artificial selection could be applied to humans in order to reproduce individuals with only the most desirable traits. So we will talk about that in class, but for now, I encourage you to Google the word eugenics. Okay, eugenics is a really dark part of scientific history, and it's really based on artificial selection of humans. Okay, Google that. Let me know if you have any questions, and we'll see you next time. Bye. That's it for this video.